We've already covered some of the important aspects of a control panel, but some might say that what we are going to cover today is the most important of all. The main switch is the one part of a control panel which has a large impact on progressing a project. We'll go into that later, but for now, don't switch off. This video is going to be electrifying. And before we get into the video, I'd once again like to ask you to like this video if you find it useful. This really does help us to dream up more concepts and exciting videos to create for you in the future.
When we look at the panel from the outside, one of the first things we see is something labeled a main switch, sometimes called an isolator. What it does, essentially, is applying or disconnecting the control panel from the power source. The control panel we have here is powered by a three-phase supply, which is rated at 415 volts AC. This in turn can be used within the panel to power single-phase devices, or 230 volts AC, by using one phase of the three-phase supply. We can also use transformers to convert AC voltage to DC voltage to power our 24-volt and 12-volt devices we briefly covered in the control panel overview video. So the main switch applies or disconnects the three-phase power that we have in the control panel. We usually designate the three phases with the following label system. L1, L2, and L3 are the three phases of the supply. N is the neutral wire. The neutral wire's purpose is to provide a path back to electrical ground to complete the circuit. When I put the main switch in the zero position, it indicates that the isolator is in the off position, and it will disconnect the power flow to the control panel. When I put the main switch in the one position, it indicates that the isolator is in the on position, and will enable the power to flow to the control panel. On the back of the door, the switch has wires connected to the terminals on the switch. You see the identifiers on the cable, L1, L2, L3, and N? These are connected to the main power coming into the cabinet, labeled L1, L2, L3, and N also. The other side of the switch connects to the distribution unit. From here, one of the phases goes to power these two power supplies. One phase comes here, and goes to the input for this power supply, the 24-volt DC one, and for this power supply, the 12-volt DC one. The input to these two power supplies can be 100 to 240 volts AC. Inside, these power supplies transform the AC signal into a DC voltage output, 24 volts in one case, and 12 volts on the other. This DC power can then be used for devices in the control panel, or for devices out in the field, too. Since we are using one phase of our three-phase supply, our input to these two power supplies is around 230 volts AC. The rest of the three-phase power goes into this terminal block and can be used to power the devices that work with three-phase power. So, the single-phase power powers these supplies, and we connect the three-phase power to these terminals here so that we can use them with devices that work with a three-phase supply. When we install this control panel in the field, the three-phase supply will be connected to the top of these terminals. Then, through this trunking, they are going to be connected to the top of the main switch that we have here. Through the other end of this switch, the terminal blocks are going to be connected to this terminal block. From here, one phase goes here to power the power supplies. And then all of the three phases also will be connected to this terminal block so that we can use them to power the devices that work with the three-phase supply. We have the three-phase supply connected on the bottom, and the devices can be connected to the top of the terminal blocks. If we put the main switch to the zero position, the incoming three-phase supply power will be disconnected. And that shuts down the whole control panel, including all of the devices that work with 24-volt DC and 12-volt DC, and also the devices that work with three-phase power.
That's it for this video. We are starting to get into a bit more detail about the inner workings of the control panel now, and thanks for staying with us so far. If you've understood everything we've covered so far, you're now well on the way to have a great understanding of how a control panel works. Add to that now the main switch function and why we use them. You'll soon be powering on your future. Again, this video was brought to you by RealParse in partnership with ProControl here in the Netherlands. They are experts at control system design and industrial automation. They have a team of world-class automation engineers and have been designing and implementing industrial control systems in different industries for many years. If you want to get in contact with them, you can check out their website at pro-control.nl. That's pro-control.nl. We'll put a link to their website in the description below the video as well. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you have learned something new from this video, it would mean the world to us to like this video. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do so. When you subscribe, don't forget to hit the little bell next to the subscribe button to be notified each time that we post a new video. If you've got any thoughts or questions, add them in the comments below. We read each and every comment and reply to it in less than a day. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.
Want to learn PLC programming in an easy-to-understand format and take your career to the next level? Head on over to realpars.com.